Peace, blessings, and love to you and your families, and may Yahweh bless the sensei as always. Thankfully, I was able to have some time to make this video. I wanted to make this video before Selection Day. And it will be called, The Mountains Will Be Shaken. I hope everybody's doing well. So let's jump right into the scriptures. Jeremiah 21 and 4. This is why Yahweh, the Most High of Yasharah, says, I am about to turn against you the weapons of war that are in your hands, which you are using to fight the king of Babylon and the Babylonians who are outside the wall besieging you, and I will gather them inside this city. I myself will fight against you with an outstretched hand and a mighty arm and furious anger and in great wrath. So let's talk about the weapons of war which are in the hands of the people, shall we? So it's basically talking about Democrats. The Democrats represent Egypt. Always keep that in mind. The Republicans represent Assyria. Democrats, Egypt, Republicans, Assyria. Okay, keep that in mind. We're going to talk about that a little later. This is also the reason why the scripture says that Dan leaps over Bashan and then he finds his way here into America. Okay, so we don't want to jump ahead of ourselves. We just want to show you this, that these are the two weapons of war that are in the land right here. Okay, Democrats and Republicans, and each time they want to make a selection, they expect you to vote. That's the weapons of war, okay? Because they are against each other, isn't that true? When they are voting, when they are debating. So again, like I always say, when I make these videos, it's never to stir up tension, but instead, I just want you to think for yourself. When I make these videos, it's never to stir up strife. It's never to spread any hate or misinformation. Me, myself, I don't vote due to the reason that I believe in the Most High. I have consecrated myself to the Most High. I have made my vows in the name of the Most High. Now, I'm speaking for myself. That doesn't mean that you don't have to vote. We all live a different path. And I'm not saying that you're not important, but what the Most High Yahweh has chosen me for in this life requires for me to stay faithful to Him, committed to Him at all causes. So therefore, I can vote. And that's why I'm making this video, so that we may see for ourselves what is considered in the eyes of the Most High righteous. This is why I want you to understand that if we are going to stand for something, then it's going to be for what is right. We will not stand for what is wicked. We will not stand with those or anything who is against the Most High, our God. So let's go ahead and look at the video.
That 1994 crime bill, it did contribute to mass incarceration in our country.
Bobby Rush, member of Congress, said the other day, I'm ashamed that I voted for the 94 crime bill. You ashamed of that bill?
Not at all. In fact, I drafted it. I know that.
There are two basic steps here. One step is you must take back the streets. And you take back the streets by more cops, more prisons, more physical protection for the people. We must take back the streets. It doesn't matter whether or not the person that is accosting your son or daughter or my son or daughter, my wife, your husband, my mother, your parents. It doesn't matter whether or not they were deprived as a youth. It doesn't matter whether or not they had no background that enabled them to have become socialized into the fabric of society. It doesn't matter whether or not they're the victims of society. The end result is they're about to knock my mother on the head with a lead pipe, shoot my sister, beat up my wife, take on my son. So I don't want to ask, what made them do this? They must be taken off the street. Unless you do something about that cadre of young people, tens of thousands of them, born out of wedlock, without parents, without supervision, without any structure, without any conscience developing, because they literally, I use myself to be moving, because they literally have not been socialized. They literally have not had an opportunity. We should focus on them now. Not out of a liberal instinct for love, brother, and humanity, although I think that's a good instinct, but for simple pragmatic reasons. If we don't, they will, or a portion of them will, become the predators 15 years from now. And Madam President, we have predators on our streets. They are beyond the pale, many of those people. Beyond the pale. And it's a sad commentary on society. We have no choice but to take them out of society. And the truth is, we don't very well know how to rehabilitate them at that point. That's the sad truth. I'm the guy that said, rehabilitation, when it occurs, we don't understand it and notice it. And when we notice it and we know it occurs, we don't know why. So you cannot make rehabilitation a condition for release. That's why in our system, there's the federal system, you serve 85% of your time. We must make the streets safer. I don't care why someone is a malefactor in society. I don't care why someone is antisocial. I don't care why they become a sociopath. We have an obligation to cordon them off from the rest of society.
I just want to say, that music was annoying. It was very hard to try to hear what he was saying, but I'm pretty sure you all got the message. But remember when he was first running for president, how he was dancing and wanting to be around the same people that he was talking about. Okay? He wanted their votes, just like now.
You know how those lids are... Because this is, well, I'm just going to speak, okay? So this is it. So you know how those lids on the Starbucks cups, they're white, right? And so if you wear lipstick, they get all over the lid. And so then I find myself in meetings if I'm the only woman. And that's kind of, and so I keep taking the lid off and having my cup out so that I don't have that big lipstick mark on the lid. So I said, can we do something about the color of the lid?
Again, I'm just showing you this so that you can see, you know, you can see the people that you will be voting for. This is from the 1987 TV show called Alf. You remember Alf, the little monster? So, it's a part here where Joe Biden is mentioned, okay? I just want you to hear it. It's nothing big, but I just thought that it was interesting.
You're in the Oval Office, the red phone rings. Soviet missiles are heading toward 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue. Do you push the button?
Can I vote for the acerbic guy in the middle?
Well, in answer to your question, as Joe Biden once said, we have nothing to fear but fear itself. And by arming ourselves against the impossible, we are preventing the unthinkable from becoming the inevitable.
Double talk. Preventing war is easy. Just tell the people who are mad at each other to kiss and make up.
International politics is very complex. The Soviets want peace and so do we, but we are separated by history, ideology, economic philosophy.
You sound just like those windbags.
No, I don't.
The Soviets want peace, and so do we, but we're separated by history, ideology, economic philosophy.
Wow! Kate, maybe you should become president.
You see how the messages were always there, hidden in plain sight.
Must be 35.
Traveling from India to California with an unshakable dream to be the scientist.
How many people are watching?
At home.
Can we tell how many, Dan?
Sure.
How many people are watching?
She's talking about how great San Francisco was before she destroyed it. A lot of talk about childhood. We've got to get to the border, inflation, and crime. Cindy's the things of which she complains.
In many ways, Donald Trump is an unserious man.
These prosecutions were all started by her and Biden against their political opponent. Me. Get that out right away.
She paid and raised bail. She paid bail to get the violent rioters in Minnesota out of jail.
Put it in there. Put it right in with the stuff, right?
With that book,
yeah. You could do it either that or something.
If they were lying about the Project 2025.
Oh, lying against Project 25, which she knows, and so do all Democrats, that I have nothing, that I have absolutely nothing to do with.
She says we all know that.
I'm not sure if this video clip is real or somebody made it up with AI, but it was interesting. However, we'll keep talking about it in the next part.